There's no doubt that the world of information technology today is operating in a multi-cloud world. Similarly, there's no doubt we're also operating in a very challenging economic climate. Now, regardless of the state of the economy, organizations should always be innovating, keep pushing themselves, keep pushing the boundaries of innovation, trying to maintain that momentum of innovation. However, when the economy is fragile, organizations often have to find a balance between that innovation with being more efficient, more strategic, optimizing costs, minimizing risk, effectively finding that balance between offense and defense within the organization. This is kind of being cloud smart, I might say. So there are definitely unique challenges to the multi-cloud environment. Now, one of those in particular is resilience. Now, why is resilience particularly important in the multi-cloud world or in a challenging economic climate? Well, don't think of resilience in the context of I need to design infrastructure to protect from acts of God. But what about something like ransomware and a malicious act of man against my organization? Now, in any economy, a ransomware is the last thing you want to happen. It could be particularly impactful to the business during a down economy, but certainly not something you want either way. And I'm not just talking about the cost of the ransomware event, if you indeed choose to pay the ransom, but what about the cost to the business operations, or potentially compromised sensitive data? More importantly, maybe even the loss of trust in the eyes of your customer. Maybe the data wasn't that significant, but having to announce this breach and losing that trust from your customers or your partners, or in some cases, if you're a public company, investors, which can be detrimental to the organization. So a really strong, a good resiliency strategy is always important, but maybe in these times, even more critical to focus on that balance between offense and defense when I'm designing infrastructure. Now, resilience is also particularly important and challenging in this multi-cloud world because of the fact that the silos that are created by these multiple clouds present this challenge that makes it difficult to enforce consistency across all of these different environments, right? Building a security posture that can be maintained across all those environments. Well, obviously, as I start putting workloads into different clouds, whether that's my private cloud or multiple private cloud instances or a VMware cloud or a native public cloud, what I'm doing is creating this much larger attack surface, which becomes more difficult to protect it effectively with all of these different endpoints and workloads in different places. There's APIs, there's virtual machines, there's containers all over the place. So to be a cloud smart organization, you need to look at your multi-cloud environment, not as the individual pieces, but in a holistic nature, and then try and build a strong, consistent security posture across all of that. Well, let's take a look at kind of four steps that you can take to try and get to this resilient architecture. Step one, we'll say, is design. So when you design this environment, what you should be looking at is the environment holistically, but with security as a core focus, not an afterthought or not something that might happen as a byproduct of a different technology you choose, but really focus in on security as part of that design process. The second step would be protect. How do I proactively protect the assets in my organization? And we could think of things like your external firewall, which most organizations already have, but taking that next step in security and attacking that lateral battleground, the lateral traffic within your data center. So internal firewalling capability. And then maybe I can add to that intrusion detection systems and intrusion prevention systems. So now proactively looking for those known bad things that could happen in my multi-cloud environment. But, you know, we're going to open ports and protocols, and those are legit ports and protocols for legit traffic. But ultimately, we're going to get to a point where we still need to monitor the environment. We need visibility into the traffic flow. So doing things like network traffic analysis or network detection and response will help us to look at the traffic in this multi-cloud environment and then correlate things together to determine whether an attack is happening. Being able to put these flows together and identify a campaign where somebody is doing something malicious, maybe leveraging those ports and protocols that we opened. It's not a known bad event, not a known bad malicious attack, but we're able to correlate those things together to determine something has happened. And then the final step would be recovery. So what happens, say a zero-day attack, and there was nothing we could have done to prevent it because there was no known signatures, but we were monitoring, we did see the attack happen, and now we have to take those steps to be able to recover. How do we get the data back? How do we get our business back up and running? And that's where recovery comes. And then the interesting part about these four steps here is, you know, the more you can do here in the front, the greater the chance that you may not have something happen on this backside, right? I hope that my monitoring tools never show a campaign, right? This correlation of flows into a campaign, because hopefully I'm doing all the things that I need to do to protect my environment from those types of things from happening. So again, we're trying to find that delicate balance between things we can do proactively and then what do we do in a reactive nature in the event that something has happened. So resiliency is taking on this whole new concept inside of the multi-cloud world. But as an organization, you certainly have the opportunity to be cloud smart and to do the things you need to do to protect as your multi-cloud environment grows.